Hello, I'm Ernest Carter of the Bluegrass Hymn Trio, and we're proud to be a part of WLJC. We've been coming here, and even back when they had the radio broadcast, since the middle 60s, and it's an honor to represent Sister Margaret and this fine TV station, WLJC, here in Beattyville, Kentucky. And I understand that I'm there just about five nights a week when you're live, and then you have two more nights, seven nights of good gospel broadcasts, and invite you to tune in each and every night here for good gospel music and preaching on WLJC, Beattyville, Kentucky.
WLJC welcomes you to have church with us for the next 90 minutes during the Hour of Harvest. Call in your prayer request or praise report now. The WLJC prayer team is standing by to talk and pray with you. We have some very special musical guests here this evening to share in song the good news of the gospel. So sit back, relax, sing along, and join in with us as we pray for you and the needs of all our viewing audience. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. Live from our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome to our service tonight. We really hope that you can stay tuned. We're going to trust that this storm will go away and not cause us any trouble tonight. And so we want to have a good service. We have a family group here that hasn't all been here for a while. So we're going to glad to have the Doan family back. So you be sure and stay tuned. Dottie has phone operators, Brother Cecil and some of his folk are up there help answer phones. And so we have a lot to praise the Lord for, and then we have things to pray about. So we welcome all of you. If you need to pray, if you need to call for prayer, that's great. And if you don't, why, enjoy the music and the singing and everything. Well, we want to share some scripture with you and trust it'll be a blessing to you. And this is a psalm about praise and trust of the Lord. And you know, those two things are really important to us. We need to praise God, know who He is, and to praise Him, and then we must trust Him. We must trust Him. We cannot go without that. All right, Psalms 34. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt His name together. I sought the Lord, and He heard me, and delivered me from all my fears. They looked unto Him and were lightened, and their faces were not ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all of his troubles. The angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear Him and delivereth them. O taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that trusts in Him. O fear the Lord, ye His saints, for there is no want to them that fear Him. The young lions do lack and suffer hunger, but they that seek the Lord shall not want any good thing. Come, ye children, hearken unto me, and I will teach you the fear of the Lord. What man is he that desireth life and loveth many days, that he may see good? Keep thy tongue from evil and thy lips from speaking guile. Depart from evil and do good. And seek peace and pursue it. The eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and His ears are open unto their cry. The face of the Lord is against them that do evil, to cut off the remembrance of them from the earth. The righteous cry, and the Lord heareth and delivereth them out of all their troubles. The Lord is nigh unto them that are of a broken heart, and saveth such as be of a contrite spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivereth them out of them all. He keepeth all of His bones, not one of them is broken. Evil shall slay the wicked, and they that hate the righteous shall be desolate. The Lord redeemeth the soul of His servants, and none of them that trust in Him shall be desolate. If we're trusting in the Lord, we're not going to be desolate. We're not going to be without hope. We're not going to be without direction. But if we trust in Him, and I love this psalm because it is so good. Because it says the eyes of the Lord are over the righteous and His ears are open unto our cries. Isn't that good to know that He is ready and waiting to hear for us and know where we are and what it's all about. And it says that we have many afflictions, but the Lord will deliver us out of them all. Didn't say in one time or one sweep, but He said He would deliver us out of them all. And so that's what we can thank Him tonight, praise Him for His goodness. We had a real good testimony today in the mail. Someone from Barberville had a daughter that had a brain cancer tumor and said she had been totally healed. And so they was praising God. And then there was other praise reports here in the studio before service. And so we just need to stop and think, well, yes, God did that. God brought us through here or this. And so we need to just thank Him for what He has done. And before we pray, here's some people that needs to be mentioned. A woman has called for a son from West Liberty that is really sick. We need to pray for the Ronald Earl Bright family because his funeral was today. Evelyn is in the hospital and they might have to amputate a leg. And also we have some friends over at Richmond. We have Raleigh and Janie Parsons, and they are on the Richmond Road there from the House of Bargains, and these folk have been friends for some time, so we want to remember to pray for them and thank the Lord for friends and for those that love the ministry and stands behind it. That's Raleigh and Janie Parsons. We appreciate these folk. All right, let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name, we do give You praise tonight because You've been so merciful to us as we look around and see the things that You have delivered and You have brought us through. Maybe the healing didn't come in one prayer, but Lord, You've been faithful to bring healing to even some of the singers tonight and to all of us, Lord. You have kept us all in Your care and how we praise You for that. Shan and Bill both being here tonight, and you've touched them, you've sustained them and helped them. And so, Father, we know there's many people looking to You. They do have trust in You, and help them to just keep looking, keep moving forward, because we know that whatever we need, it's coming, but might not be when we say so, but it will when God says so. Bless everyone, Father, that's with us. Bless our singers and anoint them, strengthen them. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, we're happy tonight to have the Doan family from over at Mount Vernon with us. And they do have CDs. You can call 606-308-1549, and they tell you all about their CDs, and they're from the Callaway Holiness Church. And so we have a lady here that's not been here for a while, so maybe she'll give a testimony what the Lord's brought her through. But let's welcome the Doan family from Mount Vernon.
Amen. Thank you, Margaret. It's good to be here with you tonight. And I'd like to say good evening to you out there tonight, and whether you're in the hospital, home, rest home, nursing home, hospital, wherever you may be at tonight, we hope we can maybe sing a song, say a word, a testimony. More than anything else, that the Spirit will just go beyond these doors tonight and reach out to where you're at. So we thank God for this opportunity that we had to be here. And I was listening to what Margaret was reading there and what she was praying in her prayer. And sometimes we think God is supposed to do things for us immediately. But God's not a worker that way. I think David, even somewhere in that psalm, somewhere close, said, weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. So one thing I know for sure, my God's always on time. He's always there when I need Him. We have things in our life that come sometimes we don't know how to handle, but if we just give it to the Lord knows how to handle it. So, and no doubt there's people out there tonight that thinks that you can handle it. But I'm going to tell you tonight, you can't handle it. I think that's what we preached on here maybe the last time we was on here in the telethon. You can't handle it. But I'm glad I got a God tonight that can handle it. He knows just what we need tonight. So we hope we can sing something tonight, and especially to you out there tonight if you're lost. We want you to know that you may feel like nobody cares about you, and may feel like there's nobody concerned about you, and maybe down to your lowest point that you've ever been in your life. But Bill, I know a man named Jesus tonight that can wipe away all those feelings. He can take away all that guilt, that shame. And I think Elsie preached the other night. He said he'd make you a brand new creature in Christ Jesus. Old things will pass away, and behold, all things are brand new. Praise the Lord. And when I got saved, I didn't know what that meant till I got saved, because I thought I was having fun. I thought I had it, you know, everything I wanted. I thought, I guess to break it all down, boy, I thought I was something, you know, back in that day when out doing everything I shouldn't have been doing, and going places and things I shouldn't have been going. But when the Lord saved me, I found out that I was a nobody. But when the Lord saved me, I became a somebody. Praise the Lord. So tonight, if you're feeling that way out there, we hope we can say something to touch you and lift you up tonight. And we got phone operators waiting upstairs for the phone calls. We want you to call in tonight. And just if you need somebody to talk to, you know, we got operators up there tonight that's just willing to talk to you. Maybe they can lead you and maybe guide you to the Lord. So if you feel like you just need help tonight, would you call in? And we'll be giving out some requests here to different folks tonight and stuff that's out there wanting us to sing a song out to them. So we'll do that. But I think we're going to start off. Connie over here was practicing a little bit, and she about forgot it while he's practicing. So maybe she'll remember it by now. So.
serving God in His holy name. No condemnation, peace and happiness. And just don't get any better than this.
Glory to God.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Praise God.
Yeah. Searched a lot of places trying to find something better. But you know what? I've not found nothing to even compare to what the Lord has got. Amen. He's been so good to me, brought me through so many things, and helped me through so many battles and so many storms. Amen. And I thought listening to that thunder outside, hearing the storms are coming, you know, you can tell when it's fixing to come. But folks, I'm telling you, that storm ain't the one that's worrying me. It's the one that's coming behind that and is the one that's worrying me. As we was talking there earlier in our prayer, the kind of shape Cecil was talking about, people was getting in, and I'm telling you, there's demonic forces and spirits out there today that I've never witnessed before.
Amen.
And I believe we're in the end time. I really believe the Bible said that it was even nigh, even at the door. And I believe, sure as the world, that it's so close that we probably don't even realize really how close that it is. I've heard it all my life, but I've never seen things like what I'm seeing now. Something that was prophesied over 2,000 years ago in the book of Daniel, 2,600 years ago. The prophecies are being fulfilled right before our eyes, 2,600 years ago. That tells me something. It lets me know that something, there's a storm. There's a storm coming, Bill. And I'm telling you, if you're not ready to go tonight, if you're ever going to get ready, right now is the time. You need to get ready. It's evil out there. I thought Timothy, I think it was in the second chapter, said that, know this, in the last days, perilous times will come. And we're in them. They're here. They're not coming. They're here. Men will be lovers of their own selves and boasters, proud blasphemers. Folks, that's where we're at today. I tell you, it'd be easy to preach in here tonight. I know we're here to sing, but it'd be easy to preach. I believe the world needs preached to tonight. I do. I feel like the world needs told that there's a heaven to gain, and I've heard this almost. There's a heaven to gain, there's a hell to shun, folks, and I'm going to tell you, right now is the time that you need to get right with God. Amen. Time is a running out. Time is a winding faster today. Seems like it's just going so fast. Life is just going so fast that we can't even hardly keep up. But you know what? We better forget all about all those things that we're facing today. Forget about all that stuff. We better get our minds on God. Amen. Folks, I'm going to tell the Christians something tonight. We better get serious with God. I see people backsliding. A lot of people don't believe in that word. But I'm going to tell you, I see people who once used to serve God, used to work for God, used to live for God. Now they're out doing every ungodly deed that you could ever imagine. People are falling away. The Bible tells us in the last days a great falling away would come. If the great falling away don't happen, the end can't come. So, folks, we're in it right now.
Amen.
Well, I better let you guys sing. Praise the Lord. I'm about to get happy, folks. I didn't come down here just to sing. I come down here to mind God. Amen. Praise the Lord. I've been pushed back in the corner long enough, ain't you? I'm telling you, folks, it's time to get on our toes and get serious about what we're doing for the Lord tonight.
Amen.
Come on, you girls sing. Whoever's going
to
sing.
Get my wife to come up and sing one. Send it out to Jerry Denny and them. They couldn't come down to church. They always ask for her to sing this song, so we'll send it out to them and all the Callaway Holiness Church and the guys and gals up at the Rockcastle County Detention Center, Audie and Mike and those guys and Vernon and Charlotte. Send it out to them tonight and everybody I work with down at NACO and Clinton Harrison.
With them, and I thank her for staying there with the kids. And
well, first I'll hear that trumpet sound. All the saints will be heaven bound. Then we'll cross over Jordan wide, stop and view the other side. Then we'll see those holy hills and the mansion he has built. Wanna be the first one. I will fly away to that land so high.
for that day, ain't you?
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Thought John said, he seen a vision. He said, what are these that are arrayed in white? And he said, thou knowest. And he told him, he said, these are those that came out of great tribulation and have made themselves white and washed in the blood of the Lamb. Amen. I'm glad I'm washed tonight. Praise the Lord. Glad I'm cleansed by the blood of the Lamb. Praise God. I guess we got a little lamb standing here. We let her sing next. She's got a good testimony, been sick, been through a lot, folks, but God's been with her all the way. So I'm sure she won't tell you about it. So we're going to let her sing, maybe tell you what the Lord's done for her.
Yeah, I thank God for getting to be back here again, and I praise Him for His goodness and His mercy. And, you know, I thank Him for touching my body. If it hadn't been for Him, I don't think I could have made it. And He was with me every step of the way.
Amen.
And I thank Him for it. I thank Him that, you know, that I'm able to go now, that I'm able to do my housework. I'm able to do my grocery shopping. I'm able to go to church. And you know, God is great.
Yes.
There ain't nothing that He can't do. And I sure praise Him for it. And I've got some dedications. Want to send this out to Bill and Darlene Cromer. And I want to send it out to Donna and George Kirby, to Dallas Kirby, and to their mother, Maddie Kirby.
And Bill Sexton and Kim, his wife.
And all of our church.
Yeah. And she's going to sing a song called He Touched Me. And Brian and Sandy, my half, you're supposed to be listening tonight. Send it out to them, too.
Thank you.
Send that out to my oldest daughter, Carolyn, to my grandkids, my great-grandkids. I want to send it out to them, too.
Thank you, Lord. Are you ready down there? Praise the Lord. I'm glad he touched me. Thank the Lord. I was down at my lowest place when he touched me. Praise the Lord. I've not forgot that he touched me either. I don't want to forget that he touched me, do you? Praise the Lord. Go ahead and sing.
I laid my guitar down. I can't hardly sing a song. I'm not singing with a guitar. I don't know. It don't slip my mind.
What you trying to sing?
Huh? Oh, I'm not afraid to bid this world goodbye. I'm not afraid to close my eyes and die. It's for this good rich I have prayed. Oh, in his arms, I'm not afraid. Oh, when I cross that old and sea, that home light is begging me. I feel no pain. I fear no harm, for I'm safe, secured in Jesus' arms. Oh, I'm not afraid to bid this world goodbye. I'm not afraid to close my eyes. It's for this good rich I have prayed. Oh, in his arms I'm not afraid. When I close my eyes in death, just fold my hand upon my chest and sing for me a pretty song. Oh, while I take my journey home, oh, I'm not afraid to bid this world goodbye. I'm not afraid to close my eyes and die. It's for this good rich I have prayed. Oh, in his arms I'm not afraid. When I close my eyes in death, just fold my hand upon my chest and sang for me a pretty song. Oh, while I take my journey home, oh, not afraid to bid this world goodbye, I'm not afraid to close my eyes and die. It's for this girl, rich I pray. Oh, in his song, I'm not afraid. Oh, in his song,
Lord. Tell you what, folks, I know there ain't nobody wants to die, but if you're afraid to die, you better be doing something about it. For our days are numbered, and when that number rolls around, Brother Bill, we're going somewhere, and it's up to you to make that decision. The Bible said, I'll set good and evil before you, and I'll let you do the choosing which one you want to serve. Which one do you want to serve tonight, folks? Which place do you want to go? Do you want to go to heaven or hell? It's entirely left up to you tonight to make that decision. Now, I'm glad I made it many years ago, and I've held on ever since. And I thought the Bible said, the one that endures to the end, the same shall be saved. It don't make no difference how long that you've been saved. If you come in here tonight, you're just as well off as us that's been saved for 40, 50 years. It don't make no difference, but tonight would be the best night that I know of for you to get on your knees somewheres and call upon the name of Jesus, and he'll open, if you'll open that door, he'll come in. But as long as you keep that door closed, he said, behold, I stand at the door and knock, and if any man will open that door, I'll come in, me and my Father, and we'll sup with him. I'm glad to be here tonight, folks. I'm glad that I got ready to go many years ago. But there was a time that if I'd have left here, I would have went to that bad place. And I'm glad I come to realize to know that there was a heaven and a hell. And we've got a heaven to gain and a hell to shun.
Yes, we do.
Sing, folks.
I'm glad that Jesus is with me. Amen.
Amen.
Well, I know that Jesus is with me when the storm clouds gather. He's standing by my side when I hear that thunder roll.
He holds.
Grace is sufficient.
Get my wife to come up and sing another one. Listen to the words of this song. They've been a many of one, turned the way of the Lord, one time too many. And death's coming to all of us. No age limit on it, no respect to person. If you're lost tonight, the Lord knocks at your heart, accept that call. This could be you if you don't.
All right, you've been listening to the singing Doan family from Mount Vernon, Kentucky, and they do have CDs. You may call them at 606-308-1549, and they'll tell you all about their CDs and where they're going to be singing. And we appreciate them coming tonight. And so we have someone named Andrew that's celebrating his 81st birthday today. They did not get a last name here on the paper, so I'm not sure what his name is. But anyway, you know, if you're having a birthday today, you know who you are, don't you? But it's always good to have at least one birthday a year. And so they're... And you can count up the numbers. You know, of course, children are a lot more excited about their birthdays than adults are, because they haven't had as many, but it's still good to have birthdays. Well, we do have a lot to be thankful for tonight. Each time that you have a birthday and you're still this side of eternity, helps you to know, hey, there's still things you can do for the Lord. And you might think, well, you're just too weak and too tired and everything to do anything, but you can still pray. If you're in your right mind, you can still pray. And we all know how much the world needs prayer today. And we think of, you hear so much evil things happening, so many people getting killed and taking out like the young state trooper from Kentucky that only 23, I think, and lost his life in a car accident. And they just got out of police school. And but, you know, his family, it sounded like he'd been involved in church, and he probably was depending on the Lord. And but, you know, the Lord sees the beginning from the end from the beginning and so forth. And He knows what's going to happen. And sometimes I believe that young people are taken away because of the evil to come. Some people cannot stand to not partake of evil that's around them. And God knows what we can handle and what we can't. And so I believe a lot of times He takes us on home to free us up. Well, we have a number of prayer requests here. That has come in. Here's another healing report from Somerset. June says the people have been praying at WLJC for her and she was healed. And so that is great. Let's see, we have Phyllis from Berea for Albert that has arthritis, and from Berea for Johnny, a stepdaughter from Perry County, and from Wayne, a mom is called for Montgomery County that has cancer. Barbara for Steve, and these does not give many details, but they're just all saying they need prayer, and the Lord knows. Hey, He knows what we need. Here's Tina that's just now taking chemo. Well, we know what all that involves. But there's many things that's happening to even to the Lord's people. I believe He's wanting us to pray more, draw closer to Him than we've ever done before, and have a greater desire, because this old world is a winding down, as the song says. Well, we want to remember that a family that lost their daughter in Boonville yesterday or last night, one in the motorcycle accident. And there are just so many things happening. And you know, my mind cannot even grasp how can anybody get up of the day and think about getting through a day without knowing that the Lord was their helper. I can't imagine that. It's just, beyond me. So anyway, there's a lot of people that are not believing in the Lord, and you know, that is one of the things the types of people that is listed when it tells in Revelations who's going to be in hell. It just says unbelievers. It didn't say you had to be a violent sinner to be lost, but if you just don't believe, that's the biggest sin you can do, is to not believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. Well, these folk are all ready to sing some more, and so we're glad to have this young lady in her striped shirt over here tonight with us, because she's been a long time. She hasn't been able to be with them, but the Lord has brought her through. She can say what the psalmist said, many trials and afflictions, but the Lord's brought her through. She's here tonight singing His praise, so that's what we need to do. All right, let's go right back to the Doan family from Mount Vernon, Kentucky.
Tell her she gets prettier all the time. She's just still shrinking. We'd like to send, I'm going to go ahead and get some requests out here before we get started. I want to send this up to Hollis Milton and his wife Myrtle up to Full Gospel Church in Camargo. And Mr. and Mrs. Van Zant. Send it over to Ray Moore over in Richmond and his wife. Send it over to Mr. and Mrs. Talby up in Georgetown, Cynthiana, Charles and Betty Talby. And a guy I know I've run into there, his name's Bob at Dairy Queen there in Georgetown. I want to send that to him. Scott and Sarah Tudor and their boys, and sure like to send it out to my wife tonight, and Donna, I miss her when she don't come with us, and my mom and my dad, she doesn't give it in, but I want to remember them, send it out to them tonight, my brothers, sisters, and I never will forget, I don't guess, there's about two events I've done here that I don't guess I'll forget. One of them was dropping the bass here one night, and I didn't know if Margaret was in the spirit or she's going to have a heart attack. So, but anyway, I remember that. I don't guess that'll ever go away as long as I got my right mind. But I thought my little grandbaby, I send it out to him all the time, to my other one, the girl, all the time. But he just had been born, and I don't know, I must have had the Bible on my mind, but his name is Isaiah. I got on here and I sent it out to my grandbabies, Kendra and Jeremiah. My wife looked over at me, she went, I didn't know what she was looking at me like that for, but after I got home, I found out. She said, his name ain't Jeremiah, it's Isaiah. So I don't guess I'll forget that one either. But anyway, I want to send it out to my daughter, Deanna Barnes, my son-in-law, David Barnes, and my little grandbabies, Kendra Barnes, and Isaiah Barnes. I got it right that time. So
I'd like to send it out, this whole program, out to all the York family, John York, yeah, and all of his sisters, and every one of them.
I hope we didn't forget anybody. We don't forget anybody intentionally, I promise. So tonight, if we didn't call your name, call us, give us your name. We'll send it out. Maybe, Lord willing, to get here again, we'll do it the next time. But just send it out to all of you after tonight. Send it up to the jail tonight also.
Send out Diane and John, too. Leroy and Flossie.
If we forget, it's only because we forgot. Okay.
Sue and Frankie.
Whole life for me is sometimes so unsettled. The way I have to move and leave my friend. And someday, hello will never end, and I'll drop my anchor on the other side of Jordan. When this old rusty ship never have to say goodbye to friends and loved ones, for that anchor will hold us for a million years and more. Oh, I wonder what they're doing. Are they busy? till I drop my anchor on the other side of Jordan. When this old rusty ship will leave the port no more, I'll never
to my mother-in-law and father-in-law back at home, Charlene and Lee and Jason and Tasha Medley and Kathy Carpenter and Johnny Carpenter. When John was on the Isle of Patmos, he was talking with the Son of Man. And the Lord said, John, go right in.
you better be ready to meet me when I stand on the judgment day. Now he said, "Mind me, go dried in the fire, melted down, turn the flames just a little bit higher." Well, don't give me no gold if it ain't been purified. Don't you know it just ain't good enough? It ain't been tried. People talk about old-time religion while living in their modern way. They like to reminisce about saints of old and how they were back in the day. Well, they've got all of those stories gathered up in their mind. Don't they know that the Lord's still looking for those just that kind? Now he said, "Find me gold, tried in the fire, a little bit higher. Well, don't give me no gold if it ain't been purified. Don't you know it just ain't good enough? It ain't been tried. Oh, tell him all about your troubles, about things you've been going through. Oh, you think you just can't make it? I'll say a little prayer for you. Well, you ain't seen nothing like it, and you're just about to lose your mind. Don't you know that it's gonna get harder if you're ever gonna be refined?" Now he said, "Find me gold, dried in the fire, melt it down, turn the flames just a little bit higher. Well, don't give me no gold if it ain't been purified. Don't you know it just ain't good enough? It ain't been tried." He said, "Find me gold, dried in the fire, melt it down, turn the flames just a little bit higher. Well, don't give me no gold if it ain't been purified. Don't you know it just ain't good enough? It ain't been tried."
To do to us. Amen. Gold, when they dig it, it's got a lot of uncleanness in it.
Amen.
Whole lot of pollution, I guess, just things that's unnecessary, unneeded. How they have to melt it and burn it and heat it and try it and until they get it down to the pure. Amen. And that's what the Lord has to do to us, folks. He has to get us, sometimes he has to take us through things, and he has to lead us to things and out of things and get us to a place where we'll pray and seek his face. And that's how he purifies us and cleanses us and lets us realize when we're straying off to the wrong path, or lets us realize maybe we said something we shouldn't have said. Or, well, I'm glad my dad calls it a dimmer switch. I'm glad I got a dimmer switch, ain't you? When I say something I know, say maybe something I shouldn't have said, boy, that good spirit will check me just like that. And sometimes I catch myself maybe fixing to do something or say something, maybe something that shouldn't be, I shouldn't be doing. I mean, folks, that's just nature. I mean, that's the nature of man, that we are easy. If we're not real easy and careful, we'll do something, maybe be led to say something quicker than what we should say it. So, well, I'm glad I got something that checks me, though, before that comes. Amen. And you know what? I don't always get checked right before it comes. Sometimes I have to get checked when I do it. So. But I'm glad that sometimes the Lord knows how to purify. He knows how to cleanse, and he knows how to heal. He knows, folks, most of all, he knows how to save you out there tonight. Amen. He knows how to save you. Praise the Lord. You may be down as far as you can go, but you know what? That's probably where God has to get your attention. You may be down to the lowest point. Even as a Christian, you may be down to your lowest point, just about ready to give up, saying God ain't going to do it. But that's right where God has to get you to be where he wants you. Amen. So, don't give up tonight. Amen. I think Cecil gave me a request that a lady in Richmond by the name of Janie wanted us to send her out a song. So we're going to send this especially out to you tonight.
Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. These mountains are too high and the valleys too wide. Down number one, it would surely be me. And I thought I could be what I wanted to be. And I thought I could build on life's sinking sand. But I can't even walk without you holding my hand. Oh Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. These mountains are too high, and the valley's too wide. Down on my knees is where I learned to stand. And I can't even walk without you holding. That I could do it all on my own. And I thought I could make it all alone. And I thought of myself as a mighty without you holding my hand. Oh Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. These mountains are too high, and the valleys too wide. Down on my knees is where I learned to stand. And I can't even walk without you holding my hand.
I like this verse. Oh, now I've made Jesus. Oh, he's my all and all. And when I'm in trouble, oh, on his name I'll call. Without you, Lord, I'd be less of a man. 'Cause I can't without you holding my hand. Oh Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. These mountains are too high, and the valley.
Send a hat out to my Uncle Jimmy Lawson and his wife Linda and Amanda Lawson. She just lost her husband, which is my uncle, 54 years old, and had to preach his funeral, and it was
probably one of the hardest ones I've ever done. So I'd like to send it out to that whole family over there, to Amanda and all those. And you got another one on your mind? No, go ahead. What you got?
I'd like to send this out to Maddie and Lee Collins' church Tuesday night. And Dennis is here. I told him what Maddie said about him, but she never said it. She's just joking. Oh, this so simple world is always full of trouble. I gave up this world to find a better home. And I know the hand of God will always guide me, and it'll always keep me happy from now on. For I've got the love of God within that makes me happy. And I know the Lord has really saved my soul. I remember when I came down to the altar, and He took away my sins and made me whole. When your friends have turned you down, the Lord will help you. He'll be there to help your troubled heart to stand. I'm so glad to know for sure I met the Master, and I'll meet you at the gates of glory land. For I've got the love of God within that makes me happy. And I know the Lord has really saved my soul. I remember when I came down to the altar, and He took away my sins and made me whole. I've got the love of God within that makes me happy. And I know the Lord has really saved my soul. I remember when I came down to the altar, and He took away my sins and made me whole. Oh yes, He took away my sins and made me whole.
Praise the good Lord. We sing one more, I guess. Yeah, we'd like to send out an invitation to come down and be with us at the Callaway Holiness Church. And I thought what you see here is what you get there, so there's nothing fancy about us. We don't program nothing before we get here. We just get up here and just more or less just obey the Spirit. So that's why we want you to come. When you come down and be with us and just come to obey the Spirit. Amen. I thought the Spirit can do more in a second than I can do in a lifetime. So that's what we need to be. And we appreciate Margaret and Shannon and Bill, all of you, for having us down here tonight. And hope we've said something out there tonight that it touched you. Maybe you're ashamed to call in, or you know, maybe you're in doubt that you want to call in. But folks, I'm telling you, you don't have to be in a church to be saved.
Amen.
Bible says anywhere, I believe anywhere you call upon the name of the Lord and with a pure heart and with a clean heart, I believe He'll save you, no matter where you're at. Don't matter if you're poor, don't matter if you're rich, don't matter if you're black, white, whatever you are tonight. It don't make, God didn't put no limits on it. I thought God has got the same love for you as He has for me, and the same as me as He has with anybody else. So out there, if you feel like because you're on drugs or because you drink or you're an alcoholic, whatever, you know what? Jesus Christ loves you just as much as He loves me. So the only problem is He's just waiting for you. I'm glad I already come. He's just waiting for you to get there. So tonight His arms are open. Praise the Lord.
Well, I Yes, I looked down that road and I wondered. Well, I saw how far I was from God. Oh, that road looked so rough and rocky. Yes, that road looked so rough and rocky. Yes, that road looked so rough and rocky. When I saw how far I was from God. Yes, I looked down that road and I wondered, oh, I wondered. Yes, I looked down that road and I wondered. When I saw how far I was from God. Oh, I got on my shoes. And I started, and I started. Yes, I got on my shoes and I started. When I saw how far I was from God. Yes, I looked down that road and I wondered. And I wondered, and I wondered. Yes, I looked down that road. And I saw how far I was from God. I got out my Bible and I read it. And I read it and I read it. I got out my Bible and I read it. Oh, it told me how far I was from God. Yes, I looked down that road. And I wondered, oh, I wondered. Yes, I looked down that road and I wondered. And I saw how far I was from God. I got on my knees, I repented. I repented, I repented. I got on my knees and I repented. And I saw how far I was from God. I looked down that road and I wondered. And I wondered and I wondered. I looked down that road and I wondered. And I saw how far I was from God. And I saw how far I was from God.
Thank you. Thank you so much. The Doan Family from Mount Vernon, Kentucky. And they do have CDs. You may call at 606-308-1549. Well, we have some wonderful news here to share. Sandra has called tonight and accepted the Lord as her personal Savior.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
And then also Shelby has called and accepted the Lord and wants to help pray for the other sick people. So that's good. And then still another one, Jewel, has accepted Jesus as her personal Savior tonight. So that's great. The Pennington family from Berea is sending in a $50 donation in honor of the Doan family.
Praise the Lord.
And here's a lady called for Geneva that from Mercer County that has inner ear infection. From Clark County, a lady with cancer. From the Broadhead Nursing Home, Ella, she wanted the Doans to sing her a song. That's Ella from the Broadhead Nursing Home. Edna from Jeffersonville, from Morgan County. Gunner is in the hospital. Harold from McGuffin County. Cindy has called. And Virgie from Mount Vernon has called. Martha from Lee County. A man from Manchester for himself. And then a call from the London Hospital. Someone is called and needs people to pray for him. From Richmond, Bertha, her family needs prayer. Kathy from Ohio has a sick child. And Mavis from Estill, I believe this is, and that has called. And from Richmond, a daughter that has cancer. Barbara from Madison, and one from Edith, and one from Pauline. And these all have called, and they have different needs, and but they really are believing the Lord. They want to trust Him for their needs. And so we know God does heal, and so we're really happy tonight to have Shan and Bill both back up here. And it just seems like it's what it should be when they're filling their chairs. And so it's because Bill, he's been trusting the Lord to keep him going, and he's got a pretty good looking garden down there, I tell you. It might not be acres and acres of it, but it's still a garden. And if the rabbits don't get it all, why, they're going to have something to eat. I thought we was going to have rabbits stew for a while, but I think they've gone away now. But anyway, God does answer our prayers, and He uses different means to do it. He doesn't always just, you know, reach out and touch you, but there's different ways that He heals us and sets us free. And so we're really thankful tonight for what He has done. All right. Seemed like this another announcement or something I was going to make, and I forgot what it is. And but anyway, we've been happy tonight to have the Doan family. And if you're ever over around Mount Vernon, attend the Callaway Holiness Church. And their phone number is 606-308-1549. And I'm sure that you'll be happy with, if Dennis wants to come up and lead in prayer, is he still in here? I thought he was gone. All right, well, we just got time to pray for these, and he might want to tell you right quick where his church is, where the church is, and if you're good at giving directions, it won't take you all day.
I can get pretty fast.
All right, and so we just got a few minutes here, so... So yes. Tell us where your church is, and then lead us in prayer.
Love to have you.
Waiting on you and Dawn to come, and we're pretty easy to find if you're familiar with the London area. Come into London, Kentucky. You can come up if you're the easiest way. We just follow 25 north, approximately 15 miles, and we're right on the side of the highway there. It's a white vinyl sided church with a green shingle roof, and it's called the Callaway Holiness Church. And we're just down home people, just wanting to serve the Lord, just wanting to make it to a better place. So. Yeah. Tonight we're going to pray over these requests, and we hope God will touch you after tonight. And I tell you, God's still a healer, folks.
Yes.
He's still a deliverer. He's still saving, and He's doing all these great things. So tonight was, if you would, just maybe even put your hands out toward the television screen tonight and just pray with us as we lay our hands upon this. And Father, tonight, God, as we come to You, Lord, God, we just thank You, Lord, for the fellowship You've given us tonight, Father. And God, we just thank You tonight for Your love, Your mercy, God, and Your kindness. Lord, we know tonight, God, there's so many afflicted, Lord God, and no doubt here in my hands, Lord, are many, God, that are in trouble, and God, many people sick, Lord, and many discouraged, God, there's just so many things, Lord, in people's lives tonight, Father, and God, we thank You for each one that's called in tonight, Lord, that has accepted You tonight as their Savior, Lord, and Lord, that You'll just give them strength, God, that they'll stand through the test and the trials, God, that may come their way, Lord, and God, we just ask You, Lord, a special touch for healing, God, tonight, Lord, Lord, that many ones, Lord, tonight that's not able to go, Father, that, Lord, just got so many things on them tonight, God, that they just can't seem to get up, Lord. And, God, we just pray Your touch. We pray You'll lead them. You pray You'll guide them, Lord. And, God, we pray You'll spread out Your love and Your mercy upon those tonight that are lost, Lord. And, God, that You'll just take over, God, in the arrangements, Lord, of marriages, Lord, that are being broken, Lord. And, Lord, hurting children tonight, Lord. And God, just so much tonight. And I pray, God, tonight you'll touch the Christian man and the Christian woman tonight, Lord. And Lord, you'll encourage us, Lord. You'll give us the strength we need. Lord, that we'll surely always be willing and able, Lord, to give you praise. And Lord, that we give you honor and give you all the glory. For we know that you gave your son for us, Lord. And we just give you all the glory and honor tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Yes. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
All right. I remember now what I had forgotten. We were supposed to, mention about Pastor Bill Wesley, his life being spared from down in Haiti. And all of you have heard that story, and he's back in Kentucky, probably at the VA hospital tonight. So that was what I was going to mention, that was great that the Lord spared his life. Yes. And I tell you, go where where Satan has full reign over these countries, and it's even worse than what it is here. So it's dangerous, but the Lord is our protector. So we're glad, though, he's back home.
Yes.
All right. Anything else you would like to share, Dennis, in the last minute?
Yes. He knows our every step. He knows our every thought. Knows our every need tonight. So if we could just learn to live our life in a way and just give it all to the Lord each day, I try to do that and get up each morning. Don't forget to read your Bible. Don't forget to pray each morning before you leave. We need this more today than we ever have. Pray a shield over your children when they're getting on that school bus and going out to the schools or the college or wherever they are, teenagers. I've never seen so much drug addiction and so many things that are just destroying this generation. And I tell you, we need to encourage them tonight that they need Jesus in their life. And I tell you, I'm proud to be a Christian. Ain't you, Morgan? I'm just proud to know that I'm a Christian, praise the Lord. So, folks, when you lose your joy, you've lost it all. If you don't, the Bible says the joy of the Lord is your strength. So.
All right. We're about to run out of time. So thanks again to the Doan family for being here. And from all of us, good night and God bless you.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope you get a blessing every time you watch. This program is available for download on your computer or mobile device at www.wljc.com. WLJC is now available on Roku and Google TV. DVD copies of this program are also available for your contribution of $15 or more. The WLJC programs, including the Hour of Harvest, are brought to you through your contributions of support. All contributions made to WLJC are eligible for income tax deduction. Thanks to all who support us. Without you, our programming would not be possible. If you would like to join our mailing list to receive our free monthly newsletter to keep you informed about what is happening at WLJC, along with our monthly musical guest schedule, call 606-464-3600 or write to WLJC, P.O. Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311. Want to hear from us faster? Join our email mailing list. You can sign up at WLJC.com. It's easy. And it's free. May God bless you.
Mercy and grace.